Thank you. Can you only imagine? Can you imagine just standing before the king? Oh, I can only imagine what it would be like when I walk by your side. I could only imagine, yeah, what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I could only imagine to be surrounded by your glory. What will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still?
This is our world. Mics, please. Thank you. Good afternoon, family. Good afternoon. We will now begin our service for our dear sister, Sally Mears. We will not be processing from the back. We will begin in one short as soon as the organist will start us off with our opening hymn, How Great Thou Art.
I am the resurrection and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore. And I hold the keys of hell and death. But because I live, you shall live also. Friends, we have gathered here to praise God and to witness to our faith as we celebrate the life of Mrs. Sally Mears, loving wife, mother, auntie, cousin, godmother, friend. And we come together in grief, beloved, acknowledging our human loss. But may God grant us grace that in pain we may find comfort, in sorrow we may find hope, in death we will find resurrection.
Amen.
Let us pray. Let not your hearts be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Father God, we give you glory, honor, praise, and thanksgiving. We thank you, dear Father, for bringing us each here to this house of faith. We thank you, dear Father, for every family that's represented here this afternoon. We thank you, dear Father, for the family that comes to bring to you and put in your care their mother. We ask, and their wife and their grandmother and their sister. Father, we ask that you would receive her. And Father, we ask that you would comfort all of us gathered here together this afternoon. We ask that you would give to each of us beauty for our ashes, that you would give us the oil of joy for our mourning, and that you would give us a garment of praise for our heaviness. Father, we ask that everything that is done in this service this afternoon be done to your honor and glory and for the salvation of your people. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Good afternoon, church. I will be reading from the Old Testament, Psalm 91, verses 1 through 6. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in the darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. Here is the reading of the Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, who gave us birth, you are more ever ready to hear than we are to pray. You know our needs before we ask and our ignorance in asking. Every member of this family and all before us, give us now your grace, that as we shrink before the mystery of death, we may see the light of eternity. And speak to us once more your solemn message of life and of death. And help us to live as those who are prepared to die. And when our days here are accomplished, enable us to die and those who go forth to live. So that in living or dying, our life may be in you, and that nothing in life or death will be able to separate us from your great love. In Jesus Christ we pray. Amen.
hymn now. It is well with my soul. We have hymnals in our pews. It's number 377. And if you're able, please stand as we sing. Number 377 in the hymnal. Be seated.
Good afternoon. First of all, my sincere condolences and love to the Mears family. I will be reading the New Testament scripture taken from New Living Translation, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 50 through 58. What I am saying, dear brothers and sisters, is that our physical bodies cannot inherit the kingdom of God. These dying bodies cannot inherit what will last forever. But let me reveal to you a wonderful secret. We will not all die, but we will all be transformed. It will happen in a moment, in the blink of an eye, when the Lord's trumpet is blown. For when the trumpet sounds, those who have died will raise to live forever, and we who are still living will also be transformed, for our dying bodies must be transformed into bodies that will never die. Our mortal bodies must be transformed into immortal bodies. Then, when our dying bodies have been transformed into bodies that will never die, this scripture will be fulfilled. Death is swaddled up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? For sin is the sting that results in death, and the law gives sin its power. But thank God, he gives us victory over death and through our Lord Jesus Christ. So, my brothers, dear brothers and sisters, be strong and immovable. Always work enthusiastically for the Lord. For you know that nothing you do for the Lord is ever useless. This is the word of God for God's people. Amen.
Blessings be upon you and the family and our church family as we celebrate the life of our sister Sally Mears. It is an honor to pay tribute and be part of the celebration of life for our former choir member, Mrs. Sally Mears. This phenomenal, beloved spiritual woman was the soul of our senior and mass choirs for many years. She not only was a part of the early development of a distinct senior choir of older adults and those who just loved the gospels for the church, but provided much of the leadership and performance of this ministry. An extraordinary and gifted vocalist, she used her voice as the instrument to inspire, uplift, console, and enriched the spirit of all, young and old, who heard her. An outgoing and warm personality, she embraced and encouraged all who sang with her. She was a mentor for other singers and would say things like, "Put some gravy on it." She will always be remembered for the great songs she brought to life. Some of her many solos and lead songs were performed at churches, community groups, and many venues. I'm blessed, better than blessed, because he lives. Probably her signature song, we'll hear it later. I won't complain. God is. Stop by the church. Jesus, I love you. This old building. Move mountains. I want Jesus to walk with me. Give me a clean heart. He's sweet, I know. Prayer is the answer. I said I wasn't going to tell nobody. As God has ordered her steps throughout her music ministry, He has now ordered her home. We love you, Sister Sally. Always missing your presence, voice, warmth, humor, and infectious personality. May you take your place in that heavenly choir, safe and resting in His bosom, sleep in heavenly peace. She once requested this song where the seniors and other mass choir would sing to be sung at such a time as this. Thank you.
Is there a family member to come forward?
Good afternoon, y'all. All right, so I'm gonna read through this. I promise I could read, I'm gonna get through it. It's a tough moment. Sally Mae Sullivan was born August 15th, 1943, to the late Sarah Sullivan in Spartanburg, South Carolina. She attained her education in the school system in the South. Sally grew up in church and loved music from a very early age. God blessed her with the gift of an amazing voice and grew up singing in church choirs, gospel groups, and accepted many opportunities to sing for various events and occasions. As a young adult, after having her first son, Jeffrey, Sally relocated to New York City. She lived for a while in Harlem, New York, where she met her knight in shining armor, Charles Sr. From their union, she had a beautiful daughter, Barbara, and two more sons, Charles Jr. and Kenneth, or Kenny. Miss Sally, or Ma, as she was affectionately called, was employed for years and later stopped working to become a devoted wife, mother, and homemaker. She provided special care to her son, Kenny, who fell ill and needed special attention and was always present for her children. Her family and she moved to Concourse Village in the Bronx and joined a nearby church, Epworth United Methodist Church, with her family. Over the years, Sally became the matriarch of the choirs and the staple of Epworth's music ministry, who brought joy to the lives of those around her through her beautiful voice and warm hospitality. Her motherly caring spirit and love for her family and others showed in everything she did. She shared a motherly and sisterly love with many of the members and seniors. Sally was also a prominent member of the Concourse Village Special Adults Choir, directed by ministers of music brother Frank Gilmore and previously Chris Guthrie and Mr. Reed, who preceded her in death. She served as the president of the choir in years prior. Thereafter, Kelly was the president. She was also a member of the Chris Guthrie Gospel Choir Group. She found solace and inspiration in the walls of her local church, where her melodious voice resonated with the hearts of the congregation. Her angelic voice uplifted many souls and added a touch of heavenly grace to every hymn sung. While Sally's gift as a singer brought her great joy, her true fulfillment came from being a dedicated mother, wife, and homemaker. She poured her heart and soul into creating a warm and inviting home for her family. Sally's love for cooking, baking, and decorating knew no bounds, and she transformed their home into a haven for every occasion. Her famous garbage can cookies and pies were to die for. From festive holiday decorations to cozy family gatherings, Sally's attention for detail and creative touch made every moment special. Family was at the center of Mrs. Sally's world, and she cherished the time spent with her husband of 62 years and they're now adult children, grands, and family. Whether it was times in Georgia or simply enjoying cruises and casinos, Sally and her husband created memories that will be treasured for generations to come. She leaves behind a legacy of love, faith, and the importance of cherishing every moment. May her family find solace in this precious moment they shared with her. On Monday, April 8th, 2024, the Lord called Miss Sally home. Her work on earth was done. Sally leaves behind to mourn husband Charles, sons Jeffrey and Charles Jr. and Yvonne, and Kenneth, daughter Barbara Muzan and Joseph, six grandchildren, Sheena, Darius, William, Trevor, and Jada, Conrad, and Danielle, 11 great-grandchildren and a host of family, Epworth and Concourse Village senior church family and friends. Thanks.
From the gospel. Following that, we will have a selection, I Won't Complain, from Sister Sharon Stukes. Let us hear the good news. Jesus said, do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. And if it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going, and I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. And because I live, you also will live. And I have said these things to you while I am still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives, so do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. And this is the word of Christ for the people of Christ. And amen.
Thanks be to God. Can you hear me? Masali to me was like a second mom. My second mom to me. We used to talk. I could tell her anything. And she would give me advice. I knew her years ago growing up in Concourse Village. Barbara, Charlie. And we always knew Miss Sally, but I learned to know Miss Sally from coming from Epworth. When I first started singing, Miss Sally was she was the one that was coaching me, because I used to crack all the time. And she helped me to become more comfortable with singing. I'm gonna miss her so much. Such a God-fearing woman. I love her. My deepest condolences to you guys. Now I'm gonna sing one of her songs. I'm gonna do my best.
Some good days, I had some hills to climb, I had some cloudy days, and some sleepless nights, but when I look around and I think things of all of my good days, outweigh my bad days, and I won't complain. Sometimes the clouds hang low, I can hardly see the road. I asked a question, Lord, why so much pain? But he knows just what's so good for me. And my weary eyes, they can't see. So I just say, thank you, Lord. I won't complain. God's been so good to me. He's been so good to me. More than anyone could ever be. Good to me. He washed every last one of my tears away, and he turned my midnights into day. So I just say, thank you, Lord. I won't complain. He's been so good to me, more than this old world could ever be. God's been so good to me. He washed every last one of my tears away, and he turned my midnights into day. So I just say, thank you, Lord. I won't complain. God's been so good to me. He's been so good to me. Anyone in this world could ever be. God's been so good to me. He wiped every last one of my tears away, and he turned my midnights into day. So I'd say, thank you, Lord. I love you, Miss Sally. I love you, Miss Sally.
Let the church say amen. Amen. And amen again. Amen. We want to honor the time frame that we have been allocated, so we're going to ask if there's one person who would like to bring remarks on behalf of the family.
Everybody, I kind of wanted to change it up a little bit and tell a story about, I had to be maybe about 5 years old. My sister was a couple years older, and usually mom was the housemaker. She was home and held the home down, and my dad was at work. So generally, when we were coming home from school one day, what we used to do is we'd kind of get ahead of her, and there was a candy store on the street when we lived in Manhattan, and we would always go in there and get our little candy or whatever on our way home, and my mother would come behind and just pay for whatever it is that we grabbed, and then we'd go on home. this one particular day, my sister and I decided we weren't going to get any candy. So what we did was we got to the store ahead of her, and she didn't know what we got. We got a mouse. It was a toy mouse. I mean, about yay big, but it looked real. So what we did was we went back home and didn't say anything to her. When she got in the house, we took the mouse and put it next to the refrigerator in the stove and laid it on the ground. So she came in the house, and we sat there and didn't make a word. She went in the back, and we screamed, "Mommy, Mommy, Mommy." She comes running out, and we point, there's a mouse, there's a mouse. She grabs the broom and starts hitting the mouse. So we're trying not to see that, we didn't want her to see we were laughing. And then when she hit it one good time, it turned upside down. It was hollow on the inside. So now she looks. And at that point, we realized this may not have been a good idea. So there was maybe about a 5 or 6 second period where it could have went either way. And then at the last second, she saw that we were laughing so hard, she had no choice but to start laughing. So I just wanted to kind of mix it up a little bit and share that story with everybody to kind of lighten things up. Thank you.
Reflect briefly from Exodus chapter 15, verses 1 through 4. And it reads, "Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. Horse and rider he has thrown into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my might, and he has become my salvation. This is my God, and I will praise him, my father's God, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a warrior. The Lord is his name." Let us pray. Gracious, loving, awesome, and almighty God, we humbly say thank you. And we thank you, Lord, even in the midst of sadness, even in the midst of grief, even in the midst of loss, because you are still God, and you still rule, and you still reign supreme. And there will still be that day, and when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing it would be. So, Lord, touch this family, comfort them, wrap your loving arms around them, allow them to know that separation is temporary, and we will gather again in your glory. In your mighty and matchless name we pray, amen and amen and amen. I want to speak quickly, but I want to make sure that I honor the life of this saint and everything I've heard. I always ask for those, you know, to whom I had no relationship, can you tell me a little something so that I can make the eulogy kind of speak to their lives? And everything I heard was about singing, about how she led this choir and that choir. And so that reminded me and it brought me to this particular passage. In this passage, we find Moses and the Israelites. Almost sounds like a music group. Moses and the Israelites, they gathered together and they began to sing. Moses and the Israelites had a song, and there's some things I need you to understand about that song that should probably be her testimony, be the reason why she sang. The first thing about that song is that it told their story. It said to all who would hear it, God has triumphed gloriously. Not just that God won the battle gloriously. And I need you to understand that if you continue to press on, God is going to win any and every battle that you face, because there is nothing that is too hard for God. So in the midst of your time of loss and hurt and pain, you may not see it now, but you will receive the victory, because your story is a story of being a people chosen by a glorious God. That's the first thing I need you to understand. But then Moses kept singing. This was verse 2. Verse 2 said, "The Lord is my strength." I need you to get that. It took a lot to be strong in the midst of captivity. It took a lot to be strong when they were being under bondage. But yet God took them from bondage, brought them up out of the grip of Pharaoh, enabled them to be able to go forth. And their enemies chased them, as enemies often do. But he brought them to a place where the water separated and they were able to walk on through. There will be a time, believe
beloved, where you're going to be able to walk on through and celebrate God's power. Why? Because God is strong and God is the source of your strength. I ask you right here and right now to claim that God is the source of my strength. So when I feel weak, I claim that God is the source of my strength. When I cannot walk on my own, I'm going to claim that God is the source of my strength. In the darkest hour, I'm going to boldly profess that God is the source of my strength. One last verse. There's one more verse in this song. Moses keeps saying, he is my God and my strength and my might, but most importantly, he is my salvation. And this is the thing for Sister Mears and for all of us. We have salvation through Christ Jesus. What does that mean, Pastor? That means that this is only a time of rest, because all the saints who have been saved are going to gather together. We have salvation, and salvation does not end at the funeral home. It does not end at the gravesite. It does not end on this side of glory. We have salvation, and our salvation is going to press on. I know that it hurts while we're in this in-between season, but understand there is an other side season, and on the other side season, we will celebrate salvation. What we see now is not what will always be, because we serve a God who went to a cross so that we may have life, and not life here in the Bronx, but life for eternity. That is the reason why she and the reason why we sing. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing it will be. Loving and all merciful Father, receive your daughter Sally Mears into the arms of your mercy. Raise her up with all of your people. Receive us also and raise us into new life. Help us so to love and serve you in this world that we may enter into your joy in the world to come. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Mrs. Sally. Acknowledge we humbly beseech you a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of eternal peace, and into the glorious company of the saints of life. And may God's people together say, amen.
Time. I know there's a time limit that we have here that we have to, for the service. So the members of the Mass Choir, please come forward, and this will be our song as we prepare. Thank you.
is the bright sunshine.
And weary.
Sometimes you feel like you wanna give up, but the rocks and the reels make the going tough. Bright sunshine.
Your hands are breathing mentor, and your feet are weary and worn.
Sometimes you feel like you wanna give up. I know the rocks and reels make the going get tough.
Church. She loved to tell other people to stop by the church sometimes.
You ought to stop by.
Tell nobody, but I
could keep it to myself.
Said I wasn't gonna tell nobody, but I
could keep it to myself.
what the Lord had done for me. You ought to have been there when he saved my soul. You ought to have been there when he wrote my name on the roll. Well, I started talking, what the Lord has done for me. Well, I said I wasn't gonna tell nobody, but I, I said I wasn't gonna tell nobody, but I, what the Lord had done for me. You ought to been there when he saved my soul. You ought to been there when he wrote my name on the road. Well, I, what the Lord has done for me. Said I wasn't gonna tell nobody, but I said I. I said I wasn't gonna tell nobody, but I, what the Lord had done for me.
Let the church say amen. Amen. We're now gonna turn the service into the hands of a funeral director.
On behalf of the family, I'd like to take this small opportunity to thank those friends, excuse me, for coming out today, supporting the family in their time of need. On behalf of Mr. Isaiah Owens, Owens Funeral Home, family themselves will thank you in a more personal matter at a later date. I'd like to thank Pastor Hayes, the Mass Choir, all the singers, participants, drummer, organist. Thank you so very much. Immediately following the service, I'll travel to Woodlawn Cemetery. There's a repast that's going to take place right after the service. Family would encourage everybody to come downstairs. I just ran downstairs, so I'm out of breath. Forgive me. Thank you once again for coming out. I'm going to turn the service back over to Pastor Hayes.
I believe we have one more family member that wanted to say something.
One way.
Saddened to learn of the loss of our dear friend and neighbor, Sally. She was an outstanding and dedicated member of the center for many years and was active in many of the activities, especially our senior choir at the center. Now she will be singing with the angels. She was always willing to help whenever needed, and she did it with a smile. May God ease your pain. We ask God to bless you with the courage to bear the sorrow that fills your heart and your soul. Sally will truly be missed by all. May God's grace and love and comfort you, and may your faith sustain you. Done in sorrow, the 19th of April, 2024, Concourse Village. And I have a picture of when we went to, I think it was Cape May, and I don't know if you remember it. You remember this? This is her son and her husband. We have a picture of them. They were so
One last thing, please. I need 6 pallbearers to meet us at the back of the church sanctuary once we're done. Thank you so very much.
Come. microphone.